gracious and holy God, we come before you this morning, Father, we're just thankful for the opportunity that we have to be here in this place of worship. Lord, we ask that as your word is read, that you would open our hearts and our minds to receive the message you have for us tonight. We ask this in the holy and precious name of Jesus Christ. Our Old Testament reading this morning comes from 2 Kings, the second chapter, verses 9 through 11. Listen for God's word to you this morning. When they had crossed over, Elijah said to Elisha, "Ask what I shall do for you before I am taken from you." And Elisha said, "Please, let a double portion of your spirit be upon me." He said, "You have asked a hard thing. Nevertheless, if you see me when I am taken from you, it shall be so for you. But if not, it shall not be so." As they were going along and talking, behold, there appeared a chariot of fire and horses of fire which separated the two of them. And Elijah went up by a whirlwind to heaven. Elisha saw it and cried out, "My father, my father, the chariots of Israel and its horsemen." And he saw Elijah no more. Then he took hold of his own clothes and he tore them in two pieces. He also took up the mantle of Elijah that fell from him, and returned and stood by the bank of the Jordan. He took the mantle of Elijah that fell from him and struck the waters and said, "Where is the Lord, the God of Elijah?" And when he also had struck the waters, they were divided here and there, and Elisha crossed over. Our gospel reading this morning comes from the book of Luke, chapter 9, verses 51 through 62. When the days were approaching for his ascension, he was determined to go to Jerusalem. And he sent messengers on ahead of him, and they went and entered a village of the Samaritans to make arrangements for him. But they did not receive him, because he was traveling toward Jerusalem. When his disciples, James and John, saw this, they said, "Lord, do you want us to command fire to come down from heaven and consume them?" But he turned and rebuked them and said, "You do not know what kind of spirit you are of, for the Son of Man did not come to destroy men's lives, but to save them." And they went on to another village. As they were going along the road, someone said to him, "I will follow you wherever you go." And Jesus said to him, "The foxes have